Hi everyone, it's Sue and welcome to my channel today. The video today is a sharing of all of the projects that I've done during September. But before that, I'd like to share a couple of channels with you. One is Aussie Scrapper and it's Sylvia, and she's part of the Auntie Vera Scrap and Craft creative team with me. The other one's channel is Rayleigh and it's Crafts from the Dungeon. So could you please just have a check out of these channels? If you like what you see, subscribe. I'm sure the ladies would appreciate some extra subscribers. And please enjoy the following video. Thank you very much. One of the little projects that I did this month was the decorated dangly paper clips that I did. And really all I did was I grabbed some paper clips because I have a lot of them. And what I did was I just simply wrapped around either a bit of fabric or a little bit of paper, whatever I could find really. And there's a little bit of lace wrapped around this one as well. Just scrap bits of paper. And I did put some little bit of gold on them. I'm not sure if you can actually see. But there was a little bit of gold, Inca gold on them as well. So basically it's just a bulb pin with the decorated paperclip and whatever little embellishments I could find. These ones were just little key charms. I have some bits of jewellery that I picked up from the op shop. What else have I got? I think that's about it. This one, little butterfly. Whoops. It's trying to fly away. We have this one. So just some little dangly bits that I will put on the end of some journals and things, I think. So just simple, quick little things that I did one evening when I felt like it. This one is sort of more of a Christmassy one. It's got a little parcel present and it's got some red stickles and it's the green paper clip. There's another one, a bit of lace. So yeah, just wrapped the lace and paper around and put the charms on. So that was just another quick little project that I did this month. And some more projects that I made this month. I spent a few evenings making these postcards. As I may have mentioned maybe before, I have joined Post Crossing, which is a group, an online group where you are randomly given an address for somebody overseas and you send them a postcard and then you'll receive one back. Now I haven't actually had chance to send any yet, simply because posting from Melbourne, Australia at the moment, as I've said lots of times, is not great. So what I have been doing is making some postcards that when I can send, I can actually send them. So I do have these ones that I've made. Now the images were from a book I picked up from an op shop. Now this had a few pages missing, so I figured, oh well, never mind. So what I have done is I've made some postcards using the images. Now I'll just bring you up a little bit so that you can see them. So this one, I did use some, I think it was ink on the background, and I just basically stamped it on. So that's Greetings from Australia. And the back, I haven't done the backs on all of them. Some of them I've just left plain where I can write on them. A lot of the time I actually prefer to put my postcards in envelopes, just because it gives you more chance to write on the back for a start, because you don't have to put the address. And I mean, you know, like if you're making a personal message to somebody, you don't really want it. Well, I don't like the idea of everyone reading it. So anyhow, another one. And all I did was basically cut the card cardstock out the size I wanted, cut the images out and pop them on, and then I printed from my computer the sentiment, or the greetings from Australia. So I've just used all the different images. I just thought the images were really great, and I thought, yeah, they make awesome postcards for people who, you know, who are overseas. So I spent quite a few evenings doing these. I am part the way through another batch using a different children's book, but sort of came to a stop. Now, this one's a bit thicker because it does have a backing on it, and it does have my sort of backing that I made. There's another one. Yeah, more kangaroos and some parrots. And occasionally I did actually put the name on them too. And we have, oops, this one. And this one. This one. And this one. So that was another little project that I did a couple of evenings. Now, I do also have another journal that I have made. Now, this journal was inspired by these little paper origami dresses that I made that I got from, I think there were a couple of different, oops, sorry, I've got it totally the wrong way. A couple of different YouTubers have done. Which I thought were really cute, and now they inspired me to actually make a journal for. And I'll just take you out again, so it's a bit bigger. This one. There we go. This is my what I call my paper doll journal, and I've just used some scrapbooking paper on the front, and it was an altered book, so I've just used some scrapbooking paper here. Now I'm not sure if I'll be able to remember all of the printables, but these were printables that you cut out and put together. I'm not sure. I will try to look them up and put them in the description box as well. So they were really cute. I absolutely love those. So they're paper pieced basically. The hair is separate to the face, to the body, to the arms. So you can paste them, put them all together. And there's another one from that set as well. Oh, there we go. It's by J. Lee Lou Etsy. So it's an Etsy store. Now this one I put together myself, and the face was from a printable that I purchased. So she was put together. I thought she turned out kind of cool. Oh dear. Now I think there's a couple more pages. Let me just find them. So as you can see, I made it out of different scrapbook papers. There we go. This one was from, it was a printable Imaginarium. And basically, although the elements, the legs, the body, all of that were separate, and you put them all together in the way that you like. So I thought they were kind of cool, very retro-y. Let me see. And there's this one here. I'm not overly happy with this page. I think the background was too busy, so that to me, I kind of spoilt it. But these images are from Tandy Art. Sylvia, I think it's Sylvia from Tandy Art, and I actually, that was a printable I purchased a long time ago, and I have done a few different things using that printable because I absolutely love her little fairy images. Let me see what else we got. Oh, I have some more of the Tandy Art images. They're ready cut out, but I haven't done anything with them yet. And I think that might be it. Yeah, so that's as far as I've got with that particular journal. But when I see some really good printables or things that I think are suitable, I will do something with them. So that's another project that that's an ongoing evening project. Another project, and I'm running out of space here. Another project I've been doing is making these little butterflies, and again, I'll have to look up the printable for these. But it was just a printable that I cut out, and I actually, this was one of the first things I cut out with my Brother Scan and Cut that I got. It was fine, except it didn't quite cut where I thought it would cut. But look, it was fine anyway. I managed to distress the edges, so that sort of hid it. And these were made just with a piece of paper, a few fabric scraps, and the little printable. And I did actually sew the butterfly onto the fabric scraps, and then I put some glossy accents, or I also used the Nuvia drops as well to put on the bodies of those. So there's a few different ones of those, just random This was another evening sort of project. It's a green one. And I have used a couple of these in my sort of journal as well. There's another one. So just a random selection of papers and fabrics that I just put together. I thought they looked really cute, actually. I was really pleased with them. I like the soft sort of colours of them. I won't show you them all because they're all very similar. Similar but different. There's a bigger one. So that was another project that I did. Whoops, it's a longer one. Okay, so as I said, I won't show you them all, but that's another project I did. I am working on another one, which thinking I'll use these, which I'll explain if I do another video. But I think that's all I've done this month, strangely enough. Okay, well, thank you very much for joining me. I hope that gave some ideas to some people, some inspiration. If there's anything that you would like me to do a video on, let me know and I can do that. But other than that, I think that's about it. So thank you very much for joining me. I hope everybody is well and good. And I will see you again soon. Bye for now.